What's up, you two? We gonna laugh tonight. It's time to get some jokes in. We want to laugh tonight. We don't want to listen to anything but some jokes and some funny stuff. But first, introductions. I am with my beautiful wife.
I'm Steph, guys.
And I'm James. As you guys know, we are the Sippingtons. We are that crew that does whatever you guys put up in that request thing, from music to comedy to whatever you want us to
skits,
movies, whatever.
Movies, anything.
Whatever. But today we're going to do some comedy. It's time to laugh. And we got a request for something called stand-up jokes that angered audiences.
But don't forget, guys, comment, like, subscribe, share this video, hit the notification bell. And, you know, I'm going dialing on this. You know, whenever we do these comments, I get a lot of hate comments. So, you know, dial in right now, 1-800-SIPPINGTONS. Please leave your hateful comment at the tone. Someone will return your call or reply to your hateful comment as soon as possible. And at the end of the day, kiss my ass.
So let's do this. Stand-up jokes that went too far.
I was there in New York for 9/11, which is just all. God, we had up with 2,400 widows. 2,400 widows, each who finally ended up with a check for $5 million each. And for over 6 years, think about it for a second. What would you rather have? Someone who farts and drools in their sleep, whose mother is living with you, or a nice check? At least there gotta be three women out there that were going, "Harry's dead, boo-hoo." And I'm gonna find those three women, and I'm gonna ring their doorbells. Yana Bernstein, it's Joan Rivers. Get what? Guess what? We found Harry! You have to return the $5 million. Good night. A pleasure working for all of you.
I have this nightmare that I go to Hollywood and find out that Mr. T is a faggot. Really, and he'd be walking up to people going, "Hey, boy. Hey, boy. You look mighty cute in them jeans. Come on over here and fuck me up the ass."
I'm just saying, I miss that guy. I miss him already. He should have told us. He should have given us a chance to say goodbye. I love, you know, I watched him on the Olympics. I watched him on Chips. I watched him on that horrible show my wife watched where he just walks around in the background. Nobody listened to him. It was so sad. And then, I don't know. It's just, he's Caitlin. Then you couldn't react. You couldn't on any level be like, "Oh my God, you know, what the F?" You, on any level, you couldn't say that. Or you're automatically homophobic. It's like, dude, I didn't hear your inner thoughts. I didn't know what you were doing. All of a sudden, you shaved your beard off. People were like, "Oh my God, that's your chin? Wow." This guy walked out, a dude came back, a woman. You're just supposed to be like, "Oh yes, anyways, Caitlin, that's what I was saying." The housing crisis. I think the bubble's creating again. It's just, God bless him.
I got
God bless her. Sorry, they really freak out about the pronouns too.
Yeah, yeah.
You say God bless him and they're like, "Her!"
Yeah.
Sorry.
You know, I consider myself fairly open-minded, but something has come to my attention I find absolutely shocking. I don't know if you've heard about it. These new grade school books for children to teach them gay lifestyles. You know what I'm talking about? One of them is called Heather's Two Mommies.
Oh.
The other is called Daddy's New Roommate. I'm going to have to draw the line here, folks, and say this is absolutely disgusting. Okay? It is grotesque and evil. I'm talking about Daddy's New Roommate. Heather's Two Mommies is pretty cool. I don't know if you want to check that out. They're hugging on page 7. Oh, go, mommies, go, go. Anyway, it makes me miss my youth. I have this belief. If that scenario is at all true, when you die and you go to heaven and St. Peter meets you at the gate, I have this belief. The first thing he's going to ask you is, you got a light? You mean y'all smoke here? Yeah, that's why it's heaven. These aren't clouds. This is cigarette smoke, pal. Hell is the non-smoking section. You want to look at them for a minute? Okay. I can't believe what they do to their bodies. It's so smelly. It smells like an ashtray. Why do they want me to smell that? God, that's hellish. Exactly. Light up and come on in. Hendrix is on harp tonight. But I think it's interesting to note how people act on religious beliefs. You know what I mean? Like a lot of Christians wear crosses around their necks. Nice sentiment. But you think when Jesus comes back, he's really going to want to look at a cross? Hell. That may be why he hadn't shown up yet. Oh, man, they're still wearing crosses, Dad. I'm not going. No. They totally missed the point. I'm not going. Forget it. I'll go back as a bunny. But,
there's no worse life available to a human than being a caught child molester. And yet they still do it! Which from, you can only really surmise that it must be really good. I mean, from their point of view, from their, not ours, but from their point of view, it must be amazing for them to risk so much.
Look at him in the back.
It was at this moment. He fucked up.
You done fucked up real bad.
Oh yeah. Wow.
That's disgusting.
I think he got in trouble.
I mean,
for that.
I understand it's comedy.
Yeah, he must have got in trouble for
now,
that.
I understand
shit.
It's comedy. But, oof.
Wow.
How do you think I feel? My last show, probably. Like, I can't key into it because I love Mounds bars. I love Mounds bars. It's my favorite thing, right? But there's a limit. I mean, I can't even eat a Mounds bar and do something else at the same time. That's how much I love it. Like, if I'm eating a Mounds bar, I can't.
He broke the internet when he delivered what he called the most offensive SNL monologue ever. Many people accused him of, what?
Sympathizing with child abusers. Whoa.
So he broke the internet with this joke.
With this joke. Wow.
And not in a good way.
Damn, Louis C.K.
Read the paper like, I have to just sit there with it in my mouth and go, why is this so good? I love this so much. And because they are delicious. And yet, if somebody said to me, if you eat another Mounds bar, you'll go to jail and everybody will hate you, I would stop eating them. Because they do taste delicious, but they don't taste as good as a young boy does, and shouldn't. To a child molester, not to me. Not to us, because we're all awesome.
Look at this guy in the back.
All right, we did it.
It's amazing they would catch them, and it wasn't just enough to catch them, but they had the Divine Witness Protection Program. Now find the priest, here's the pedophile, here's the priest, find the pedophile, find the priest, find the pedophile, there, blah, blah. Here we go, we're going to say it again. Here we go. Don't you ask, don't you tell, you might end up right in hell. Here we go, here we go. Here's your check direct from Rome. Buy yourself a brand new home. Moving around, moving around. Isn't that amazing? The Pope.
So they said in 2007, he refused to apologize when the Catholic Church was outraged by his joke.
And the inability to tell the priests and pedophiles apart from each other.
So he refused to apologize. Well, I mean, it's a lot of molestation going on from what I understand in the Catholic churches.
Yeah.
And that's you know.
It's pretty rampant.
I don't, you know, I my prayers.
They move priests around and do things to these kids and let them go.
But that's everywhere, too. I'm not just saying just in Catholic churches, yeah. Guys. I'm not just saying that. It's everywhere, you know. But they're saying that he refused to apologize for this joke.
Applause break number 2. But it's amazing when the Pope gathered all the cardinals in Rome and went, the only problem is he's dressed like Liberace's stunt double. Oops! I have a solution, though. For problem priests, little thing, a shock collar, if they go near a kid, it's like, you know, Timmy, oh. Tommy, I think, Sally.
The people in your line, they're so important, aren't they? Yeah. Really? They don't seem very important. Not the way you scroll through their names on your contact list like a gay French king. Who pleases me today? Who shall I favor? Who shall I delete?
I've changed. Not as much as Bruce Jenner, obviously. Now Caitlyn Jenner, of course. What a year she's had. She became a role model for trans people everywhere, showing great bravery in breaking down barriers and destroying stereotypes. She didn't do a lot for women drivers, but... you can't have everything, thank you.
So I heard that the guy came into the theater about 25 minutes into the movie. I don't know if you've seen the movie. The movie's pretty much a piece of crap. And, yeah, spoiler alert. And I know that, you know, none of that had happened. I'm pretty sure that somebody in that theater about 25 minutes into realizing it was a piece of crap probably was like, oh, fucking shoot me.
Okay, so this is, this was a crash joke because the shooting in a movie theater had just happened. In 2012. So.
Oh, that was a little rough.
Yeah, but he apologized.
He apologized? He
eventually apologized.
Okay, Dane. Oh, that's Dane.
Let us know, guys. Do you think people are a little bit too sensitive with all of these jokes? Especially, you know, do you think it just was maybe just a little too soon for him to say it? Or do you think people are just a little bit too sensitive? Now you can't say the F word. You can't
say the N word.
You can't say the little people. You can't say midgets. Like, that's not.
And she just said it.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry. Little people. I'm sorry if I offended anyone, but I'm just saying, you know, these are all things that are highly criticized. And let us know if you feel like people are just getting a little bit too sensitive these days. Or do you think people have legitimate reasons for these things to be upset about this? Comment down below.
I would love to be gay. I'll tell you why, because I'm a man's man. I like men. Men like me. We like each other.
Okay.
I hate women. Women hate me. We hate each other. The only reason I couldn't be gay is because I can never fuck a man. Because I can never fuck something that I respect.
So he's disrespecting the gay people. He's disrespecting women. All in the same joke.
Yes, all in the same joke. He can never have sex with a man, he can never have sex with somebody he respects. Because he respects a man, but he doesn't respect a woman.
But he can never F a man.
Right.
Because a man that's gay.
Because it doesn't turn him on. Correct.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah. So that's just offensive all across the board.
Yeah.
Or let me know, guys. Is it offensive to you?
Let me know.
You know, I mean, comment. Like I said, some people are very offended by these things and some people aren't. I believe some of this stuff was offensive to me, but some of it wasn't either. You know, I'm not going to say everything in here I was offended by, but I can see everybody's point of view. Yeah. Okay?
That Louis C.K. though was over the top. The one with the
kid.
That was a little bit out. I heard about this kind of, but I didn't really pay attention. I knew he said something offensive about something like that, but now this is my first time actually watching what he said. I'm like, oh.
We were in Atlantic City one time, remember? And everybody walked out. I wish I knew this comedian's name. I can't remember her name for the life of me.
In Atlantic City.
But she did the Sandy Hook joke.
She did her joke was about abortion, and she said she killed more kids than Sandy Hook.
Massacre.
You should have
like
seen
that.
The audience, people like that was sitting
there.
Everybody just
walked out. No,
just walked out.
People got up and walked out.
And this is around right when it happened. And she just standing, looking silly, smiling.
Yeah. And like all the other people that were coming up, the other comedians that were coming up after her and the ones that went before her were like trying to signal her off stage and stuff. I think it was Sandy Hook.
Oh, with a kid, with a guy who came into the school and, you know, and killed the little kids.
With all the little, like, 5 and 6 year olds. Yeah, I believe it. Guys, forgive us if we're wrong, but yeah, I believe that's what it was. But that's what she was referencing. Yeah. And she was saying that's how many abortions she had. It was a bad scene.
We just looked.
I just held my head down the whole time. You know, and like I said, it was so offensive. People walked out. And as people was walking out, she was cussing them out.
Yeah. And she's talking mess to them.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know, sometimes you go a little bit too far. You should let things
settle
a little bit, and then maybe, because I mean, it was like that. It was a open wound that's just fresh. Maybe you shouldn't touch it. As far as your career is concerned, like, I don't care if you do it, but as far as your career is concerned, maybe you better relax and let time pass before you do something like this, especially if you're just coming up in the ranks. Because I think this girl was like some up and coming comedian. I haven't heard from or about her since, but.
All right, but I feel like now if you're doing it for that, then you're just really doing it for your career. You're only doing it. You're only filtering, holding back yourself because you're so busy just trying to get ahead. Like if you think it's something offensive or something that's going to hurt somebody's feelings, then and it's out of character for you. You wouldn't say it whether it's going to hurt your career or not. You know what I mean?
Well, I mean, there's
some people who say, and I believe certain people say certain things for shock value, too, to grow their career. Mm-hmm. Like, it could go either way.
Yeah, I heard about quite a few comedians starting off that said some shocking things, and then you never heard from them again.
But then, this guy said, he blew up the whole internet.
Literally like the Kathy Griffin that did the head cutting thing with the president.
Trump, yeah.
And from that point on, all the things she was doing with Anderson Cooper and the New Year's Eve celebrations and all the people that wanted her, now nobody wants to hire her and stuff like that because
she did blacklisted.
That. I think she's still blacklisted. I'm not sure, though.
Yeah, I don't know, guys. It's a crazy topic, a crazy situation. Comment down below and let us know because this video is kind of long. I'm sorry, guys. We went on and on. But we love you guys. Get your laugh on. Get your comedy on. Don't get too much into your feelings. People say I'm in my feelings too much. I try not to be. You know, I'm trying to loosen up a little bit. You know, maybe I'll drink a little bit more and I'll be getting a little bit more looser.
Yeah. And I like that.
We love you guys. We out.